Hello, everybody. This is LaToya Okia, your spiritual life coach and motivational speaker. Y'all come on in with me. Come on in. As you come in, share the live. Glory be to God. As y'all come in, share the live. Come on in, share the live and tag. Make sure you tag, share, and like the video. To God. Y'all come on in. Come on in. To God. Y'all come on in, come on in. D Valentino, you feel that? I know you feel that love, because I was praying before I came on to the live. I'm just flowing right on out of prayer and just flowing right on into the live. So the anointing that you feel as you come in, y'all just let it do what it's trying to do. God is imparting an anointing on you. Let me tell y'all, he knew every single person that was going to be on this live, because I prayed. Do you understand me? I told God, I said, God, I don't know. I said, but Lord, you know. I said, you know. And I said, God, you know the people. Oh my God. I told God, I said, Lord, you know the people. You know the people that's getting ready to be on this live. You know the people that's coming. Glory be to God. You know the people that's coming. And I told God, I said, Lord, every single person that's going to be under the sound of my voice. Oh my God. Every single person that's going to be under the sound of my voice. I told God, I said, Lord, regulate their minds. Regulate their minds. Because let me tell you something. God said this virus. Oh my God. God said this virus, baby, God said it affects your mind before it even make it to your body. Do you understand me? God told me, God said it's affecting the minds of the people. God said, I need you to pray over their minds, regulate their minds. And let me tell you something, baby. I pray that the Lord will regulate every single mind on this live tonight. Every single household that's represented on this live tonight. Let me tell you something, baby. I've been with my daddy and I ain't coming to play. Do you understand me? I ain't coming to play. Y'all share this live. Share this live. God needs some soldiers. God said, where the soldiers at? God said, I need some soldiers, baby. God said, I need some ride or die folks in the spirit. Do you understand me? Glory be to God. God said, I need some ride or die folks in the spirit, baby. God said, I need some folks that gonna bust in on the devil territory and they ain't gonna be playing. Oh my God. Baby, let me tell you something. You might not feel like you got no power, but I came to tell you, you got some power tonight. Do you understand me? God done gave you some power, baby. And God said, you think what you're going through is a bad thing, but God said, I put you in the fire so I could show you what was in you. Glory be to God. God finna show you what's in you, baby. You ain't even know it. God said you finna find some strength that you ain't even know you had. Glory be to God. Y'all finna find some strength y'all didn't even know y'all had, baby. I see y'all, I see y'all mounting up with wings like eagles. Do you understand me? I see y'all running, baby. And the Lord said, you will not get weary. God said, I'm finna give y'all a new strength, baby. Let me tell you something. I don't care what finna hit your door. I don't care what finna hit your house. God done anointed you for the fire, baby. Glory be to God. God done anointed y'all for the fire, baby. God said, oh my God. God said, baby, when you were going through the trials of life and you thought I went down, God said, baby, that's when I was the closest to you. I feel God moving. Do you understand me? God said, that's when I was the closest to you, baby. God said, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. I will be with you even unto the ends of the earth. Glory be to God. Even unto the ends of the world. And God said, baby, even after this life, God said, I'm still with you. God said, I'm still with you. And you know why he's still with you, baby? Because your life belongs to him. You belong to God. You in this world and you done forgot who you are. Oh my God. But I came to remind you who you are tonight, baby. You are God's child. Glory be to God. You belong to God. Do you understand me? You belong to God. I'm trying to stop rocking, y'all, but I can't sit still because I feel the power of God. I feel God moving. And let me tell you something. Every single person, I ain't playing either. Every single person that's under the sound of my voice, if you don't get it tonight, baby, it's because you don't want it. It's because you just flat out don't want it. Because God finna save every single person that's on this live tonight. God finna fill you with his spirit, baby. Because these are the last days, baby, that the prophet prophesied about. That these are the last days. And God is going to begin to pour out his spirit. I know y'all feel that. Oh, my God. God is going to begin to pour out his spirit upon all flesh. God said, I'm going to pour it out on everybody. God said, whether they want it or they don't want it, they finna get it. God said, you finna start speaking in tongues, baby. You finna start having dreams. You finna start having visions. You finna start prophesying. Your children gonna prophesy. They gonna speak in unknown tongues because they gonna be speaking to the glory of God. Glory be to God. They ain't gonna know what fell on them, baby. God said, I'm finna let it all fall on you. His presence is gonna fall on you, baby. Where, let me tell you something. Wherever you at, you better not let this anointing pass you by. You better soak in this stuff like a sponge. Do you hear me? You better soak it in. Oh my God, you better soak this in. Glory be to God. I'm talking to the young folks. Do you understand me? I'm talking to the babies. I'm talking to the teenagers. I'm talking to the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. Nobody is exempt from this word. I'm talking to everybody. Glory be to God. The gospel is tailor-made just for you. Do you understand me? And God said, I'm letting this come upon you. Because God said, I need to show you. Oh my God. I need to show you that my hand is in all places. God said, my hand is in all places. God said, I got my hand on the situation. And God told me, God said, I got y'all in my hand, baby. Let me tell you something. You are in the hand of God. I don't care if you done tested positive. I don't care if you got a diagnosis. I don't care if you've been displaying symptoms. You are in the hands of the mighty God. And God going to bring you out of this. And God said, baby, this ain't nothing but a test of your faith. He's bigger than COVID-19. Do you understand me? I hear the Lord say, I am bigger, baby. He's bigger than the universe. Come on, somebody. He made the universe. God told me before I got on this live, God reminded me who he is. God said, do you know who your daddy is? Oh my God. I'm talking about your spiritual father, baby. I ain't talking about your natural father. I'm talking about your spiritual father. Y'all share this live if you ain't already shared it, baby. Tag your family members. Tag your cousins. Tag your nieces. Tag your nephews. Get them on this live. Share to any groups that you might be a part of, baby, because God is doing something. God is moving. I feel the hunger of the people. Y'all don't feel that. I feel the hunger of the people. God said y'all hungry. Oh my God. God said y'all hungry, and God said y'all thirsting after him, and God said he gonna get ready to fill you, baby. Oh, he finna fill you, because the Bible says that those that hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be filled. Wherever you are right now, baby, just reach out. Oh my God, it's in the atmosphere. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say, it's in the atmosphere. It's in the atmosphere. My healing is in the atmosphere. If you on this live, baby, and you under the sound of my voice, and you done tested positive, oh my God, I hear the Lord say, baby, your healing is in the atmosphere. God said, reach up and get your healing. And God said, you got to hold on to that thing for dear life. Let me tell you something. When God make you a promise, you better hold on, baby. Because when God make you a promise, the devil is coming. Do you understand? Me, he coming to ride you. He coming to throw everything at you that he can find, baby. And you gotta ride that promise till the wheels fall off. God told me, God said, woman of God, I made you some promises. God said, baby, whatever gonna hit your door, God said, you better know it is not unto death. Glory be to God. The enemy can't have me. He can't have my children. He can't have my family. He can't have, come on somebody, he can't have the divine ones. because you covered, baby. But you got to know that. Somebody comment on this live, baby, say, I got to know that. You got to know that. It don't do for me to tell you that, but you got to know that. Because I hear the Lord say, you going to come out, but it is given to you according to your faith. And I came to tell you, baby, I don't care how much you cry. Oh, my God. I don't care how many tears fall from your eyes. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. It takes some faith. Glory be to God. Ooh. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say, without faith, you can't please him. God ain't moved by your crying. Oh, my God. Let me tell y'all something. This is what he told me, y'all. He said, I'm not moved by your crying. We want God to feel sorry for us. God said, the only thing moved me is faith. Oh, my God. Stop begging and asking God and start thanking him for what's already yours. That's what's going to move him. That's what's going to move God. I know what I'm talking about, baby. You got to stop begging and crying and praying. When you pray, you got to pray and tell God, I thank you. Tell him, I thank you for my healing. I thank you for my deliverance. I thank you for bringing me out. I thank you for taking me through this virus. I thank you for protecting my family. He ain't did it yet, but you got to tell him, thank you, baby, like that thing is already doing. And that going to move God. Do you understand me? God said, when I see my child praying with faith, God said, that moved me. That moved God. Faith will stop God in his tracks. Glory be to God. Faith will stop him in his tracks. Glory be to God. Let me tell you something. God told me, God said, you ain't even got to live no kind of way. God said, I reign on the just as well as the unjust. God said, I'm talking to the sinner man on tonight. He talking to the sinner woman on tonight. You think you done did too much and God don't want you no more. You think God don't hear you. Let me tell you something, baby. Faith will move God. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you a crackhead. I don't care if you a prostitute. If you got faith, that's going to move God, baby. God said, all I need is somebody that's crazy enough to believe what I said. Glory be to God. We think it's about a title. It ain't about no title, baby. The only way you gonna please God is through faith. For God said, some of these folk with titles ain't got no faith. It take faith. Without faith, you can't get nothing from God. I came to tell you, baby, that faith is the currency in the kingdom. Glory be to God. Faith is the currency of the kingdom. In this earth realm, money is the currency in the earth realm. If you got money down here, baby, you can get anything you want. Oh, my God. If you got money, you want that car. They say you got the money. Yes, baby, you can have that car. Oh, my God. You want that new house, baby, you got the money. The man say, yes, you can have that. You can have that house. But God, baby, when you come to get something from God, God asking, God want to know, do you got some faith? Oh, my God. God said, do you believe that I am? Because before you even come to God, you got to believe that he is who he said he is, and that he is a rewarder to those that diligently seek him. And I prayed and I told God, I said, Lord, everybody that's reaching out to you right now, I said, God, I want you to not only heal them, but I want you to make them whole. Every time Jesus healed somebody, he said, you are healed and you're made whole. And he told them to go and sin no more. God don't not only want to heal you, God want to heal you. He want to make you whole. He want to bring you out. And he wants you to use your life to make manifest the glory of God that is within you. God said, I ain't saving you just for this season. God said, what you going to do when I bring you out of this thing? God said, that's what he concerned about. That's who he going to save. That's who he going to heal. He want to know who going to give their life to him. Who going to use their life for a sacrifice. God said, I ain't in the business of saving folks for a season. God said, I want all of you. Oh, my God. I want all of you. And God said, I require something from you. Glory be to God. Come on over to this side, baby. Come on over to the winning team. Do you understand me? Let me tell you something, baby. The Bible says that many are the afflictions of the righteous. I ain't telling you we don't go through stuff over here on this team. We still go through stuff. Oh, my God. But with God, your burden is light. Oh, my God. His yoke is easy and his burden is light. Glory be to God. Y'all share this live if you ain't already shared it. Share this live. Let me tell you something. It ain't no old folks gospel. It ain't no 30-year-old gospel. It ain't no 40-year-old gospel. Do you understand me? This thing is for the babies. Oh, my God. Because God said, if I have to, baby, I will take the babies from the mother's womb. Do you understand me? God said, if I got to, baby, I take the babies out of your arm. Oh, my God. This ain't no old folk gospel. I hear the Lord say, everybody that's breathing better get with this. Oh my God. God said, you got to get with it, baby. And you got to get them children on board with it too. Because God said, baby, when the spirit of death start walking, it don't discriminate. Do you understand me? God said, death is an equalizer and it don't discriminate. It don't care how old you are. It don't care what color your skin is. It don't care how much money you got. Death is an equalizer. And when it come for you, baby, it ain't checking for none of your statuses. It ain't checking for your popularity. Oh my God. It ain't checking for your bank account. It ain't checking for your social status. But when death come for you, baby, glory be to God. I hear the Lord say, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Harden not your heart. His yoke is easy and his burden is light. Now, that ain't no promise that you ain't gonna go through nothing. God didn't tell you you weren't gonna go through nothing. You gonna go through some things. You gonna cry. You gonna get sick. You gonna shed some tears. You gonna take some, you gonna have some bumps and bruises on your body. Oh my God. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, baby. But God will deliver you out of every one of them. He will deliver you. He made a promise. And for many of you that are on this live tonight, God said, I made you a promise. Ooh, God done made you a promise, baby. And I came to declare it in the midst of the crisis. Oh my God. I came to declare it in the midst of COVID-19 that the Lord has made y'all some promises. Glory be to God. And I came to let you know, baby, that before God made that promise, he knew about COVID-19. Oh my God. He knew about everything that was going to come up on the scene. And God ain't worried. And I hear the Lord say, don't you throw away your faith. You better hold on to your faith. You better ride your faith till the wheels fall off. And when they fall off, you better stick them back up there again and keep on riding. Glory be to God. Keep on riding. Don't you throw away your faith. He's bigger. Oh my God. I hear the Lord say, I'm bigger. Do you understand me? God said, I'm bigger than anything that could ever come up on you. God told me, God said, do you know who your daddy is? Oh my God. God said, do you know who your spiritual father is? God said, baby, I stood at the beginning of time. Oh, that's what he told me, baby. God said, I am the author. God said, I am Alpha and I am Omega. Oh my God. He said, I am the author and I am the finisher of your faith. God said, I stood up in Genesis and I spoke to the earth and I told the earth, let there be light. Oh my God. And the Bible says light was. Oh my God. God said, I walked up to something that was black and void and didn't have no shape, baby. And he opened up his mouth and he spoke to it. Glory be to God. And I hear the Lord say, baby, you were made in my image and you were made in my likeness. Oh my God. God said, you just like me, baby. And God said, you better open up your mouth and you better speak. There's power in your tongue. Oh my God. Life and death lies within the power of your tongue. It's in your tongue, baby. Somebody comment on this live, say it's in my mouth. My deliverance is in my mouth. My healing is in my mouth. Everybody that has tested positive for COVID-19, I came to let you know your healing is in your mouth. Oh my God. You better open up your mouth, baby. You better speak that thing. You better declare your healing in the face of the devil. It's in your mouth. Because you just like your daddy. And your daddy walked up to something that didn't have no shape. He walked up to something that was black and void. And he opened up his mouth. And he said, let there be light. And I hear the Lord say, baby, you better look at them test results and say, let there be healing. Glory be to God. Woo! I feel God moving. God said, look at that test result, baby. Don't you look at what it looked like in the natural. But I hear the Lord say, I need you to look through the eyes of faith. Oh my God. God said, I need you to look through the eyes of faith. I know the doctor said you tested positive. But I hear the Lord say, look through the eyes of faith. Woo! Get them test results, baby. And hold them up to God. And tell God, let there be healing. Oh my God. Let there be healing. Every single person under the sound of my voice, we're going to come in agreement for everybody that's tested positive. For everybody in the future that will test positive. We're going to come in agreement for God, folks, tonight. Comment on this live, baby. Say, let there be healing. Woo! It's in your mouth. You better open up your mouth. You better speak that thing. And when you type it on this live, you got to speak it out of your mouth, too. And you got to feel that thing down in your bones. Tell the devil, let there be healing. And you know what? It's going to be just like how it was when your daddy spoke and healing was. Because the Bible say when he said, let there be light, baby, light was. Oh, my God. And God said, this is good. Uh-huh. God said, this is good. And God said, that's the way you're going to be when you open up your mouth just like your daddy. And you speak to them test results. And you tell them test results, let there be healing. Oh, my God. And when you go back to the doctor and they say, we don't know what happened to the virus. Oh, my God. We can't find it on the scan. Oh, my God. We can't find it on the radar. Then you're going to be just like your daddy, baby. You're going to say, this is good. Uh-huh. This is good. This is very good. Glory be to God. Don't you throw away your faith. Don't you throw away your faith. Your faith is your confidence in God, baby. It is your confidence in God. Oh my God. In just a minute, I'm going to get y'all to drop y'all locations because we're going to release these prayer missiles tonight. Oh my God. We're going to release these prayer missiles in the name of Jesus. Oh my God. For everybody that done tested positive, baby. For everybody that's displaying symptoms. Oh my God. We're going to release these prayer missiles on tonight. Glory be to God. Let me tell you something. Prayer will go where you can't go. Oh my God. You might be locked in the house. You might be quarantined, but prayer will go where you can't go. Oh my God. Prayer will change some things. Prayer will change your situation, and it'll go where you can't go. Glory be to God. You can sit right here in Dothan, Alabama, baby, and you can say a prayer, and God will release that missile all the way across the world. That thing will go all the way overseas, because God said, I cannot miss. Ooh, he don't miss, baby. He is God, and there is none like him. God said, I cannot miss, and I cannot lie. God said, if I spoke it, you better believe it. And God done spoke some things over y'all. And you better know you ain't checking up out of here until the promises of God are made manifest in your life. I ain't playing with this thing tonight because the devil ain't playing. And God said, I need some radical folks for me. God said, I need some soldiers for me. Glory be to God. Come in on this live, baby. Say, I'm a soldier. Ooh, say, I'm a soldier, baby. God needs some radical folks. Cause this is a radical virus. Do you understand me? This is a radical virus. This thing is sweeping. Oh my God. It's spreading. Do you understand me? God said, I need some folks that are going to get radical in prayer. God said, I need some folks that are going to get radical, baby. They're going to get down on them knees and they're going to release these prayer missiles out to my people. Cause the power of life and death is in their tongue. It's in your tongue, baby. You walking around thinking you got to go somewhere. God said, that's why I set you down. Cause God said, I wanted you to know that that power was in your tongue. It's in your tongue. All you got to do is speak it. Ooh, y'all so anointed, baby. God done let the fire fall on y'all and y'all just don't know it. But God said, you finna find out. Ooh, God said, you finna find out what's on the inside of you. Uh-huh. It ain't just me, baby. God said, what I do, you can do. Do you understand me? God said, you finna find out what's on the inside of you. Let me tell you something. I hear the Lord say, you not strong. You don't think you strong. But God said, baby, you gonna find out the strength you got. You have no idea how strong you could be until being strong is your only option. And God said, for some of you, being strong is going to be your only option, baby. Uh-huh. God said that survival instinct going to kick in. Oh, my God. That survival faith going to kick in. Do you understand me? Uh-huh. God said, for some of y'all, he finna activate your spiritual fight or flight. Oh, my God. He finna activate that spiritual fight or flight, baby. And God said, y'all going to put the devil to shame. You going to surprise yourself because you ain't even know you had this stuff on the inside of you. I speak it in your life right now. I speak life over you. Every single person under the sound of my voice, I speak life over y'all. Everybody that's been affected by COVID-19, I speak life over y'all. God said it's in y'all mouth. You got to open up your mouth and you got to speak it, baby. Life and death is in the power of your own tongue. Y'all got power. Ooh, ain't that special about me, baby? I just came to tell you, you got some power. Do you understand me? You got power, baby. The devil don't want y'all to know that. He don't want y'all to know y'all got power. He wants y'all to think y'all got to go get it from somebody else. God put everything you needed on the inside of you, baby. And he set you down so you could see what he put in you. Because long as you were going to keep running to everybody else, you couldn't see what was in you. But God said, I'm sending you down. Because God said, you going to prophesy. Oh, my God. God said, you going to pray. Oh, my God. God said, you going to lay hands on your children. God set you down for a reason. Glory be to God. Get ready. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say, get ready. Ooh, you better get ready. Because God said, y'all finna have to lay hands on y'all family members. Do you understand me? You're going to have to lay hands on your children. You better get ready. Oh, my God. Get ready, baby. Get ready. This is training. Do you understand me? We in boot camp. Uh-huh. This is spiritual boot camp. Oh, my God. You better get ready, baby, because you're going to have to lay hands. And don't you be afraid, because the Lord has put the anointing in you. God has put the power in you. And I hear the Lord say, baby, all these lives I've been giving y'all, you didn't know you was in training. Oh, my God. You didn't know you was in boot camp, baby. God was preparing you to walk on water. Now, I hear the Lord say, water walkers, walk. Woo! Out of that boat, see. I hear the Lord say, water walkers, it's time to walk. Oh, my God. It's time to walk, baby. Oh, my God. For when Peter saw Jesus walking on the water, oh, my God, he told Jesus, he said, Lord, is that you? Oh, my God. If it be you, bid me to come to you. Oh, my God. Jesus told Peter, come on out the boat. Oh, my God. And I'm telling everybody under the sound of my voice, God is calling you out the boat tonight. God said, you can't stay in the boat no more. I'm calling you out the boat. God said, come on out of that thing and walk on this water. Oh, my God. You better get out and walk on this water. And don't you be afraid, baby, because the Lord got power. Let me tell you something, baby. When you walking in the kingdom, when you walking with the kingdom, God said, I got the power to turn that water into concrete. Oh, my God. God said, I turn that water into concrete. And God said, you will walk on solid ground. Ooh, God said, y'all getting ready to walk on solid ground, baby. The devil thought he drowned you, but God said, I'm getting ready to turn that water into concrete. And God said, you gonna walk on water, baby. Oh, my God. I know y'all feel that. Oh, my God. Comment on this live, baby. So I feel it. I feel it. I feel it. And as you say, I feel it, God is gonna give you the anointing. God is gonna give you the power. And God said, baby, go and lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover. You gonna do it. Oh, my God. I'm gonna do it, Tanya. Yes, baby. You gonna do it. Oh, my God. The pastor, no, 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 no. The prophetess, no, 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 no. The apostle, no, 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 no. God said, you gonna lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover, because you are water walkers. And I hear the Lord say, walk. Woo. Jesus. Walk on this water, baby. You were ordained to walk on this water. I've been training you. I've been preparing you. Now, the Lord says, it's time for you to walk. Out of that bullshit. It's time for you to walk. Open up your mouth. God says some of y'all, he done already gave y'all the gift of tongues, and y'all scared to open up your mouth. You better open up your mouth. And when you open up your mouth, I hear the Lord say, you're going to begin to speak with the tongues of fire. Oh, oh my God. Glory be to God. For those of you that have been praying for the gift of tongues, you've been asking God to release your gifts. All you got to do is open up your mouth. Your faith is what activate the gift. I was walking around with my gift for a long time, and I didn't even know I had it. And something hit me upside the head and said, fool, open up your mouth and just start speaking. It's in you. It's already in you, baby. God ain't got to come hit y'all upside the head. He done already gave you the fire. It's in your tongue. Oh, my God. And God said, baby, with this gift, it's only activated by faith. It takes some faith, y'all. You're going to feel crazy at first, but you got to push past that crazy feeling. You got to keep on going. You got to keep on going, because let me tell you something. Your flesh will never understand the things of the spirit. You trying to understand what God wants you to do through your mind, but you never going to understand it through your flesh. This is a spiritual thing. Somebody comment on this live, baby, said this is a spiritual thing. This is a spiritual thing. You ain't going to never understand if you keep trying to analyze it with your mind. Stop thinking and start walking. Woo! Drop that in the comments, baby. Somebody need to hear that. I hear the Lord say, stop thinking and start walking. Ooh, get out the boat and start walking, baby. And you're going to find out that you are a water walker. You're a water walker, baby. You were ordained to be a water walker. Ooh, and God done turned that water into concrete. And you sitting in the boat shaking. And I hear the Lord say, you better step out on faith. You better walk on that water. You better show the world what I put on the inside of you. God done put some gifts on the inside of y'all. God done put some rubies and pearls and diamonds on the inside of y'all. But you sitting there with your mouth closed. Baby, I hear the Lord say, you got to open up your mouth. You got to show the world what I put on the inside of you. Glory be to God. Open up your mouth. Show the world what God put in you, baby. God said, this your time to shine. Ooh, somebody comment on this live, baby, said, this is my time to shine. This is your time to shine, baby. Everything that you've been doing up until this point, I hear the Lord say, it led you up until this moment right here. Oh, my God. This is why you were born. Do you understand me? You were born to speak at a time like this. You were born to minister at a time like this. You were born to prophesy at a time like this. You were born to use your gift at a time like this. The devil want to try to make you think it's all over. But I hear the Lord say, I'm just getting started. Where my soldiers at? Where my water walkers at? God said, I'm just getting started, baby. Comment on this live, baby. Say, I am a water walker. I'm getting ready to walk on water, baby. God ain't lost his power. God is calling y'all out the boat. Jesus told Peter, come on out the boat. Oh, God. But let me tell you something, baby. When you step out that boat, when you step out that boat, baby, don't you start looking around at everybody else. Oh, my God. Don't you start worrying about what everybody else doing. Don't you look at the situation. But you better keep your eyes on Jesus. Oh, my God. You better keep your eyes on Jesus, baby. Because the Bible says that when Peter took his eyes off of Jesus, oh, my God, he began to sink. Glory be to God. Jesus was walking on water, and Peter was right there sinking, drowning. Glory be to God. What was the difference? It was the faith. Oh, my God. The difference was their faith. Do you understand me? You got to have unwavering faith. I don't care how the wind blow. I don't care how the storm blow in your life. I don't care how the rain pour in your life. You got to have unwavering faith. You got to hold on to your faith, baby, because your faith is your confidence. Your faith is what turned that water into concrete. Glory be to God. God said, keep your eyes on me. Oh, my God. Let me tell you something, baby. You finna get ready to see what you never thought you would see. Oh, my God. But I hear the Lord say, keep your eyes stayed on me. Do you understand me? I'm telling y'all something tonight. God said, don't you look around at what's going on around you. God said, you out here on this water because God said, I done called you out the boat. And God said, I need you to keep your eyes on me. Don't you look to the left. Don't you look to the right. And you better not look behind you. But I hear the Lord say, you better keep your eyes stayed on me. And God said, long as your eyes are on me, God said, you're going to continue to walk on that water. Oh, my God. God said, you're going to keep doing miracles, baby. You're going to keep doing the impossible. You're going to keep doing what man said couldn't be done because with God, all things are possible. Glory be to God. Keep your eyes stayed on Jesus. I don't care what it look like. You better keep looking to Jesus. Because the minute you take your eyes off of God, you're going to sink. Glory be to God. You're going to sink, baby. But God is so merciful. Oh, my God. God is so merciful, baby. The Bible said that when Peter began to sink, he began to cry out to God. Oh, my God. He began to cry out to God and say, Lord, save me. Oh, my God. Somebody comment on this live, baby, said, Lord, save me. Ooh, God said, some of y'all, baby, you done came out on this water. And God said, you started looking around at your situation. Glory be to God. You started looking around at everybody that was getting sick. Oh, my God. You started looking around at everything that was missing out the stores. Oh, my God. And God said, you took your eyes off of me. And God said, you done started to sink. Oh, my God. You done started to sink in this water. Glory be to God. You done started to sink in your fear. But I hear the Lord say, call out to me. God is telling you to call out to him tonight. God said, call out to me, baby. Comment on this live. Say, Lord, save me. Ooh, that's a short prayer, baby. It ain't but a 3-word prayer. But God said, I heard you when you said, Lord, save me. Glory be to God. God said, I heard you when you said, Lord, save me. And God said, I'm coming to see about my child. God is coming to see about you, baby. I don't care where you at. I don't care what you're dealing with. I don't care what you're going through. God said, I heard you when you said, Lord, save me. And I'm coming to see about my child. The Bible says when Peter said, Lord, save me, Jesus reached over. Oh, my God. He reached over and pulled him up. Oh, my God. He reached over. He was still standing on the water. Oh, my God. And Peter was right there sinking. Glory be to God. And the Bible says Jesus reached over. Jesus getting ready to reach over, baby. I see God in the spirit. I know y'all feel that. Oh, my God. I see God in the spirit, baby. God said, I'm reaching over. Oh, my God. God said, my children have started sinking in fear. Oh, my God. They done got caught up by what they see. And God said, I'm reaching over. Woo! He reaching over for y'all tonight. God said, I'm going to pull you back up. Uh-huh. God said, I'm going to sit your feet on solid ground. God said, I'm going to turn that water back into concrete. Because God said, you're going to walk on this water. You ain't going back in that boat. Do you understand me? God said, you're going to walk on this water. Because you were born to be a water walker. You are a water walker, baby. And you were born for this time right here. You think that this thing was finna end, but God said, I'm just getting started. Do you understand me? God said, I'm just getting started. God said, my promises are getting ready to be released in the earth realm. I told y'all earlier today, God told me today when I was standing in my kitchen, God said, woman of God, tell my people that everything that they put their hands on in this season, God said, I'm going to bless it. Do you understand me? I hear the Lord say, I'm going to bless all the work of thy hand. God said, I'm going to bless it. God said, if you put your hand on it, baby, I'm going to bless it. You better write that book. Do you understand me? You better sing that song. Oh, my God. You better write that poem. Do you understand me, baby? You better start that podcast. You better start that YouTube channel. You better start back preaching. You better start back singing. You better start cooking. You better start doing whatever your gift is. Because God said, I'm going to bless all the work of thy hand. I know what he told me. God said, we in the ark right now because I'm flooding the earth. Oh, my God. God is flooding the earth, baby, just like he told Noah. God told Noah and his children. He said, get in this ark. Oh, my God. And God said, shut the door. Glory be to God. And God said, when you shut this door, don't you let nobody come in. Glory be to God. Y'all think it's a bad thing to be shut in. God said, it's a good thing, baby. It's a good thing. Do you understand me? It's a good thing. Oh, my God. Because God said, I'm doing something in the earth realm. Oh, my God. I'm doing something in the earth realm. God said, I'm flooding the earth realm. Uh-huh. He ain't flooding it with water, baby, because he made a promise with Noah. Oh, my God. He came into a covenant with Noah. Y'all ain't know every time you see the rainbow, baby, that's God reminding the earth of his promise. He made a promise with Noah. He said, I'll never flood the earth with water again. Oh, my God. But he flooding it with sickness. Do you understand me? God said, I'm flooding the earth realm with sickness. Uh-huh. And God said, I need you to stay in the ark, baby. That's what he told me. Uh-huh. God said, I need you to stay in the ark. God said, you stay right here. Don't you move. Oh, my God. Because God said, I'm doing something. And God said, when I finish doing what I'm doing, God said, you're going to be just like Noah. God said, you're going to step out on this earth. God said, it's going to be new land. Woo! God said, this thing going to be new, baby. Uh-huh. God said, he doing something. It might not look like God's hand is in this, but let me tell y'all something. Don't nothing take God by surprise. God ain't surprised. Glory be to God. He always got a backup plan. Oh, my God. Somebody comment on this live, baby, said God always got a backup plan. He ain't never worried. He ain't never scared. God ain't anxious. God ain't got PTSD. God ain't worried. God ain't stressed. God ain't on Prozac. He always got a backup plan. Oh, my God. Because he is Alpha and Omega. Do you understand me? He is the beginning and he is the end. God said, I started this thing and God said, I'm going to finish it. Without him, there would be no us. Do y'all understand that? Without him, there would be no me. There would be nothing. He stood at the beginning of time and he spoke. And he said, let there be. And everything was, baby. Everything came from God. And God said, I've been telling y'all for the longest, you can't pack me in no church. You can't put me in no building. You can't pack me in no building. God said, I'm too big for that. God is too big for that, baby. You can't pack him in nothing. God said, that's why I put the kingdom on the inside of you. The kingdom is within you. I don't care how many churches they shut. I don't care how many doors they shut. God said, it won't stop my church that I built on the inside of you. Oh, my God. Because he asked the disciples, he said, who do men say that I am? Oh, my God. Peter began to tell him, he said, I say that you are Christ. Oh, my God. You are the Son of the living God. Jesus began to tell him, he said, flesh and blood did not reveal that unto you. Oh, my God. But my Father, which is in heaven, revealed that unto you. Oh, my God. Then Jesus told Peter, baby. He said, upon this rock, oh my God, upon this rock, in other words, upon this knowledge that you have of who I am, I'm going to build my church. Oh my God. I hear the Lord say, upon this rock, I'm going to build my church. God said, I'm going to build a new church. It ain't going to be church as usual. Do you understand me? God said, I'm sick of your religious doctrines. Glory be to God. I'm sick of your religious traditions. I'm sick of your rituals. I'm sick of you getting set in your old ways. God said, I'm building a new church. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say a new church. A new church. And God said, this church that I'm building, God said, all my folks know that I put the kingdom on the inside of them. You are the church. You are the church that the world is seeking. You don't even know what you got in your belly, baby. You got power in your belly. And don't you say that you don't, because you do. You just don't know what's on the inside of you. But I came to remind you of who you are in the spirit, baby. Glory be to God. You are not a physical body having a spiritual experience. Do you understand me? You are a spiritual being having a physical experience, baby. You more spirit than you are body. Glory be to God. You are a spirit, baby. And the Bible says that God is spirit. Oh, God is spirit, baby. I know y'all feel that. God said, I blew my spirit in y'all. Oh, my God. And God said, he blowing on you tonight. Because God said, when I blew on you the first time and I put my breath in you, God said, you forgot who you was. Oh, my God. He blowing on y'all tonight. God said, He's blowing his spirit on you again, baby. And he gonna build a new church. Glory be to God. God said his new church, baby, they ain't gonna be confined to no building. Do you understand me? God said they gonna go out into the uttermost parts and they gonna preach my gospel. Oh my God. Because God said I ain't coming back until my gospel done been preached in all of the world. We got a job to do. Water walkers. Do you understand me? We got a job to do. This ain't no time to give up. This ain't no time to back down. This ain't no time to sit down. We got a job to do. Oh my God. God said all of these things are going to come, but these are things that are just signs. They are signs to let you know that the end is coming, but it ain't time yet. Oh my God. I know what God told me. Comment on this live, baby. Say it ain't time yet. God said it's just like a mother when she in birthing pains. Oh my God. Glory be to God. It's just like a woman when she's going through birthing pains. Oh my God. Y'all know the first couple pains you start to have, you feel like you about to go in labor. But God said it don't be time yet. Oh no. You be running to the hospital like, is the baby finna come to the doctor? Like, no baby, I'm finna send you back home because it ain't time yet. Oh my God. You get all kind of signs that let you know that the baby on the way. But God said it ain't time yet. And I hear the Lord say, baby, y'all seen earthquakes, in divers places. Y'all seen famine in the land. You seen pestilence. God said all of these things were labor signs. Do you understand me? They were labor pains to let you know that the baby is on the way. Oh my God. But God said it ain't time for the baby to be born yet. I'm letting my people know. Warning come before destruction. Glory be to God. The only way you know that baby coming, baby, you start getting them pains. Oh my God. You start getting them labor pains, baby. The water ain't broke yet. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say the water ain't broke yet. God said I ain't broke the water in the spirit yet, baby. It ain't time yet. God said I need my folks to rise up. I need my water walkers to stand up. I need you to proclaim this gospel. Glory be to God. I need you to proclaim what I put on the inside of you. I need you to manifest. I need you to show the world what I put in you. Glory be to God. I told y'all, baby, you ain't gonna know how strong you are until being strong is your only option. And God said for many of you, baby, being strong finna be your only option. Oh my God. I don't care how much I sit here and try to preach it to y'all. You gotta see this thing for yourself. You gotta feel this thing for yourself. And I hear the Lord say for many of you, you getting ready to feel this thing for yourself. You gonna meet some things. You gonna walk up on some things. And God said the power that I put on the inside of you is gonna rise up because you gonna have to lay hands on your grandmama. Oh my God. You gonna have to lay hands on your granddaddy. You gonna have to lay hands on your children. Oh my God. But God said, baby, don't you be afraid, because God said I have put the power on the inside of you. Woo! See, let me tell you something. The devil thought everything you went through that broke your heart, everything that when he made you cry, when them folks left you, oh my God, when they used you up, God said the devil made y'all think that that was the end. But God said, you ain't even know I was anointing you. Oh my God. Your anointing come by your trials that you were able to go through, baby. Your trials that you went through that would have took other people out, God said, I anointed you. He anointed you for this time right here. So don't you tell me you ain't ready, because you are ready. Oh my God. You ready, baby. And you ripe. Oh my God. I hear the Lord say you are ripe for the picking. And if you think I'm talking to you, I am talking to you. Because guess what? God said my gospel is tailor-made. Do you understand me? The gospel is tailor-made just for you. It's just for you. Oh my God. God is talking to you. And God said you know exactly who you are. He's talking to you. The gospel is talking to you. Glory be to God. God said, I anointed you. Now walk, water walkers. Walk on water. Glory be to God. Sylvia Sanchez, I hear the Lord say, you a water walker. Oh my God. You are a water walker. And it's time for you to walk in the spirit. Glory be to God. Sylvia, I hear the Lord say, walk, woman, walk. Glory be to God. Walk in the spirit. Don't be afraid, for I have not given you the spirit of fear. Glory be to God. But I have given you the spirit of love, of power, and a sound mind. Y'all better have a sound mind, because let me tell you something, baby. You got to stay with God. Stay with God. Glory be to God. Stay with him. I don't care what come. I don't care what go. Stay with him. Because he's bigger. Oh my God. God said I'm bigger than COVID-19. I'm bigger than the universe. I'm bigger. Do you understand me? He's bigger. Y'all drop them locations. Drop them locations. And don't you worry about Blakely, Georgia, baby. Because I done sent the missile to Blakely, Georgia. I done sent the prayer missile to Dothan, Alabama. Oh, my God, baby. I sent the missile before I got on this live. at your location, baby. Come at your location. Drop your location. Because we're going to release these prayer missiles tonight. We're going to release these prayer missiles tonight. I ain't even praying specifically for a person that tested positive. Because God said it's going to be many more positives. Oh, my God. It's just a few now. But God said it's going to be many more. But I hear the Lord say this sickness is not unto death. It is not unto death. It is for the glory of God. You got to have some faith. Because without your faith, baby, it's impossible to please God. I send the missile to Ozark, Alabama on tonight. Glory be to God. I send the prayer missile to Augusta, Georgia on tonight. It's going to hit in Ozark. It's going to hit in Augusta. And it's going to tear it up. Glory be to God. I send the missile back to Blakely, Georgia on tonight. Glory be to God. I release 10,000 angels to Blakely, Georgia. I release 10,000 angels to Edison, Georgia. Y'all better release them angels, baby, because God done gave y'all charge over the angels. I release the angels to Jonesboro, Georgia on tonight. I send a prayer missile to Arlington, Georgia on tonight. I send a prayer missile to Kinsey, Alabama on tonight. It's going to hit in Kinsey, and God said it's going to tear it up. Oh, my God. I send it back to Dothan, Alabama on tonight. Glory be to God. I send it to Columbus, Georgia on tonight. Glory be to God. God, you got some children in Columbus, Georgia that need you. And I send a prayer missile to Columbus, Georgia on tonight. God, you are bigger than this virus. You bigger than any negative situation that they facing right now. I send the missiles. I sent it to St. Petersburg, Florida. Oh, my God. Arlington, Georgia. Glory be to God. I sent it to Fort Gaines, Georgia, in the name of Jesus. I released the prayer missile, and God done packed healing on the inside of the missile, baby. I sent it to Graceville, Florida, on tonight. Y'all drop them locations. Drop them locations. I ain't playing with this thing. I'm sending these missiles. And God said, baby, all I need is somebody. Oh, my God. All I need is somebody to be crazy enough to believe what I said. That's right, baby. I send it out to the nation. Woo! I send it to Italy on tonight. Glory be to God. I send it out across the nation. Oh, my God. I send it out across the globe. Oh, my God. I send it to Oklahoma on tonight. I send it to Bainbridge, Georgia on tonight. I send a prayer missile to Albany, Georgia on tonight. Glory be to God. Is there anything too hard for God? I hear the Lord say, I am God, baby. And there is none like me. Glory be to God. I send the missile, baby. God said, I'm releasing this thing. The angels done packed the missile full of healing, full of breakthrough, full of deliverance. And God said, when these missiles hit y'all location, baby, it's going to shatter the enemy. It's going to shatter that sickness. It's going to shatter that virus in the name of Jesus. Because God said, I'm bigger than COVID-19. Oh, my God. I send a missile to Atlanta, Georgia on tonight. I send it to Tallahassee, Florida on tonight. In the name of Jesus, glory be to God. I send it to Houston, Texas on tonight. Y'all share this live if you ain't already shared it. I send a missile to Cuthbert, Georgia on tonight. If y'all got some elderly family members, comment the town, the city, the location that your family members are in. Glory be to God. I send 10,000 angels to the bedside of everybody that's been tested positive with this virus, everybody that's sick and shut in, all of the bereaved families, I send a prayer missile. Oh, my God. I send a prayer missile. I put comfort in the prayer missile. Glory be to God. To those of you that have lost people to this virus, I send a prayer missile. I pack it with comfort. Oh, my God. I pray that the Lord will comfort you. I pray that the Lord will give you rest. Rest in God, baby. Oh, my God. Rest in Him. I send a prayer missile to Jackson County on tonight. Glory be to God. I declare and I decree that this missile shall hit Jackson County and it's going to tear it up. Glory be to God. I'm sending a missile to Tulsa, Oklahoma on tonight. Glory be to God. I hear the Lord say, I got some children in Tulsa that need me. Oh my God. God got some children in Tulsa that need Him, and I'm sending a missile. I'm sending a missile. Glory be to God. I'm sending a missile to Nigeria on tonight. Oh my God. I'm sending it all the way across the globe. Oh my God. Because God said, I'm bigger than what you're facing. Oh, my God. I'm bigger. And I hear the Lord say, I got Nigeria in my hands. Oh, my God. God said, Nigeria is in my hands. And God said, is there anything too hard for me? I hear the Lord say, I am Alpha and Omega. I am the beginning and I am the end. Oh, my God. God said, I got the whole world in my hands. Do you understand me? God said, I got the whole world in my hands. And God said, all of y'all can lean on me at the same time and I won't give way. Oh, my God. All of y'all can call on me at the same time. Oh, my God. And God said, I will answer you. Glory be to God. I send the missiles to every location that's dropped on this live tonight. I send the prayer missile. I send the missile. I send healing. I send deliverance. I send breakthrough to Athens, Georgia on tonight. I send deliverance to Leesburg, Florida on tonight. Glory be to God. I send it to the prisons on tonight. Glory be to God. I send it to the hospitals on tonight. Oh my God. Glory be to God. I send it to the healthcare workers. Oh my God. To all of the people that got to stand on the front line and fight this virus and take care of these people in their sickness. Oh my God. I send it to the healthcare workers on tonight. Every nurse, every doctor, every CNA. Oh my God. Every person that works in healthcare, I send a prayer missile to you tonight, baby. You're going to tend to these people. You're going to help these people heal. And this sickness shall not cover you. This virus shall not overtake you. I hear the Lord say, I shall shield you. I shall protect you. Glory be to God. God said, care for my people. Tend to my people. And God said, I'm going to watch over you. I won't let nothing harm you. Glory be to God. I send the missile to Damascus, Georgia on tonight. I send it to Lawrenceville, Georgia on tonight. Oh my God. Glory be to God. I send it to Camilla on tonight. I'm releasing it in the name of Jesus. Every single person that's under the sound of my voice. Every household that's being represented on this live tonight. Every family that's being represented on this live tonight. I send the missiles. I send the prayer missiles. To San Antonio, Texas on tonight. I send the missile, baby. Oh my God. Let me tell you something. God finna work a miracle in San Antonio, Texas tonight. Oh my God. God is gonna work a miracle. God is gonna do what man said couldn't be done. Because I hear the Lord say, with me, baby, all things are possible. Oh my God. With God, all things are possible, baby. God said, I need some radical folks. God said, I need somebody that gonna walk up. Oh my God. I need you to be like I was when I stepped up on the scene. I hear Jesus talking. Oh my God. Jesus said, I need you to be like I was when I stepped on the scene. Oh my God. They had buried Lazarus in the tomb. Oh my God. Jesus said, I stepped on the scene. Glory be to God. And I hear the Lord say, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Because you just like your big brother, baby. You better rise up. You better walk on this water. You better walk on this water, baby. And you better let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Don't you throw away your faith. Your faith is your confidence in God. And I hear the Lord say, baby, you just like Jesus. God said the earth rim, you battling COVID-19 right now. God said you carrying your cross. Because I heard God said, must my son bear this cross alone and all the world go free? Oh, no, baby. There's a cross for everybody. There's even a cross for me. I got a cross I got to carry. I preach the gospel, but I still got a cross I got to carry. Oh, my God. But I hear the Lord say, I'm bringing you out. I hear the Lord say, it is not unto death. I don't care what the enemy throw on me. It's not unto death. And I'm going to ride this thing till the wheels fall off. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. I hear the Lord say, if you got to go down, you better go down fighting. You better go down fighting. You better fight the good fight of faith. Do you understand me? Somebody comment on this live, baby, said the good fight of faith. Ooh, you better fight the fight of faith, baby. Stand. Woo. I hear the Lord say, having done all to stand. Oh my God. Stand therefore with your loins girded about with truth. Oh my God. You got to stand in the midst of this crisis. Glory be to God. You got to stand in the midst of this virus. Glory be to God. Stand, baby. Stand. Woo. You were built to stand. You were born to stand. Glory be to God. Stand on the promises of God. Because let me tell you something. The promise is what keep me. The promise is what keep me breathing. The promise is what keep me living. The promise is what wake me up in the morning. Because every day when I wake up, that old devil, he come. He come and he try to come in with depression. But I tell the devil, no. Oh my God. My God done made me a promise. Oh my God. He woke me up this morning. He let my eyes see daylight. And just because he did that, baby, I know my purpose is still in full effect. Ooh, I know my purpose is still on go, baby. I'm on go and I'm ready. I don't care if I got to do this thing virtual. I don't care if I got to do this thing on the internet. I don't care. Because the devil know, baby, when he mess around, let me get that mic in my hand and I get on the stage, it's over. Oh my God, it's over with. Do you understand me? He going to get this pressure. Oh my God. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say he going to get this pressure. Oh my God. The devil finna get this pressure. All the pressure he done threw on me, I'm finna throw it back on him. He finna get this pressure, baby. He had me shut up with my mouth all my life. I was scared to speak, but he finna get this pressure. Glory be to God. Comment on this live, baby. He throw that pressure on you, you better throw it back on him. Glory be to God. That sickness hit your house, you better throw that pressure back on him. You better pray so, baby, till they shake the gates in heaven. Oh my God. The Bible says that when Paul and Silas were locked up in the jail, one of them prayed and the other one sung praises unto God. Oh my God. Let me tell you something, baby. The men of God prayed so in that jailhouse. God shook the jailhouse doors. Do you understand me? God sent the earthquake. They prayed so, baby, they didn't stop praying. Oh my God. I hear the Lord say, pray without ceasing. Glory be to God. God said, you better pray and you better sing praises unto me. And God said, I don't care if I gotta send an earthquake to deliver you. God said, I'ma shake the jailhouse doors. I'ma shake whatever that problem is that had you bound. And God said, he got to let you go. Oh, God, I don't care what sickness. I don't care what they said couldn't be healed. I don't care what they said didn't have no treatment. Jesus said, I walked up to something that was dead. Jesus said, Lazarus was dead, baby. He had been dead for 3 days. He was stinking in the ground. Oh, my God. He was stinking in the tomb. Oh, my God. And Jesus said, I walked up to the tomb. And I said, Lazarus, come forth. Glory be to God. I'm preaching this thing. Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth. Oh my God. And I heard the Lord say, baby, Jesus had to call him by name. Oh my God. He had to call him by name. Because if he would have said, come forth, baby, everything that was dead would have got up out of there. Oh my God. That's just how much power he got when he talked, baby. And I want to let you know that you just like your daddy. You got so much power in your mouth. God said, whatever you speak, you better be specific with what you say. Because whatever you say is going to come to pass. You better watch what come out your mouth. And you better only speak what you want. Because Jesus said, if I would have said, come forth, baby, every dead man in that tomb would have got up. Oh, my God. Because he heard the master when he talked. Oh, my God. He heard the master when he spoke. The master said, get up. I don't care if it's dead. I don't care if it's stinking. I don't care if it's rotted. I don't care if it's diseased. I don't care if it tested positive. When the master say, get up, you got to move. Sickness, you got to get out of my way. Glory be to God. And I hear the Lord say, I'm calling y'all tonight. God said, come forth. Oh, my God. Glory be to God. Michelle Price, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Oh, my God. Shaquilla Curry, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Glory be to God. Tori, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Oh, my God. Chad Hunter, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Oh, my God. God is calling you. When the master speak, you got to answer. Oh, my God. You got to answer on tonight. Woo. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Melinda Wade, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Come forth, come forth, come forth. Oh, my God. Star Brown, I hear the Lord say, come forth. Come forth, come forth. Jesus said, I'm calling y'all, just like I called Lazarus. I told you, baby, Lazarus was dead. Oh, my God. The bugs had done started eating on his body. But when Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth, the bug that ate the bug, oh, my God, it had to spit him out. Do you understand me? It had to spit him out, and Lazarus had to get up. Oh, my God. When Master said, come forth, baby, he had to get up. I don't care what was bounding him. This man was dead. Do you understand me? He was dead and gone. But when Jesus opened up his mouth and he spoke and he said, Lazarus, come forth. Baby, Lazarus got up. Do you understand me? The Bible said he was bound, baby. They had them wrapped him up in the tomb. Oh, my God. He started hopping to Jesus. Oh, my God. Jesus told him to loose him and let him go. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. God telling me to loose y'all tonight. God sent me to tell you, baby, God finna loose you tonight. Oh, my God. God said, I done called you to come forth. And God said, when you got up, the devil still had you bound. But I hear the Lord say, loose him and let him go. God loosing y'all tonight. Oh, my God. Every single person under the sound of my voice, the Lord is loosing you. God said, come forth. Oh, my God. And God said, loose them and let them go. Woo. Glory be to God. Loose them and let them go. That's my child. Oh, my God. That's my child, devil, that you got bound up. Oh, my God. That's my child that you got in sickness. Oh, my God. And I hear the Lord say, loose my child and let them go. Glory be to God. Let him go. The devil got to let you go. I don't care how long he done had you. I don't care what kind of test result they gave you. I hear the Lord say, I'm calling you forth on tonight. God said, loose my child and let him go. Glory be to God. He got to let you go, baby. He done had you. Oh, my God. I hear the Lord say, the devil done had his foot slit on some of y'all necks. But God said, baby, he gonna loose you tonight. He gonna let you go. If you messed around and stepped off in this life, I don't care if you on the replay. If you messed around and stepped off in that thing, the devil gotta let you go. He gotta let you go. God is breaking generational curses tonight. God is freeing y'all tonight. God is delivering y'all tonight. And I hear the Lord say, go and sin no more, baby. Oh, my God. Let me tell y'all something. I'm looking for the testimonies. Y'all some powerful men and women of God. Do you understand me? Don't you look at what you're dealing with right now. Don't look at what you look like right now. Oh, my God. Don't look at what you just did. Do you understand me? The devil want to try to beat y'all down with y'all past. He want to try to beat you down with what you did 5 minutes ago, what you did yesterday. Let me let you know something, baby. You are the righteousness of God. I'm the righteousness. Yes, baby. You are the righteousness of God. And God don't play about you. But it don't do for me to tell you that. You gotta know that. Oh my God. You gotta know that you know that you know. Oh my God. You gotta feel that thing down in your bones, baby. Cause feeling get the blessing. Oh my God. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say feeling gets the blessing. Ooh. Feeling gets the blessing, baby. You gotta feel that thing. If you done tested positive, if you got symptoms or whatever you dealing with. Cause there's so many people dealing with other stuff other than COVID-19. Whatever you dealing with. You gotta feel your healing in your body. You gotta feel that thing. Do you understand me? Long before the doctor tell you, baby. You can't wait on the doctor to tell you. You gotta feel that thing right now. Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say, feeling get the blessing. I know what I'm talking about. Feeling get the blessing. When you tell God, thank you for my healing. Ooh, I feel that thing. I feel it. They gonna look at you like you crazy. They gonna be like, didn't you just test positive? You like, yeah, baby, but I feel this thing in my bones. They gonna look at you like you crazy. Like, how you? I feel this thing in my bones, baby. Because I know that with God, all things are possible. Glory be to God. With God, all things are possible. With him, he cannot lie. He cannot fail. That's right, baby. Feeling get the blessing. Feeling get the blessing. Just like when I released this prayer missile. It's all about your feeling in your body. If you felt it when it hit, then it hits. Oh my God. It gotta be in your body. You gotta feel that thing for yourself. They can't tell it to you from the pulpit. You gotta feel this thing in your body. You gotta feel this thing while you sitting in your recliner in your living room. You gotta feel this thing when you in your shower. You gotta feel this thing when you doing your laundry. You gotta feel it. And let me tell you something, baby. When you feel this thing in your bones, oh my God. When you let God abide in you, you ain't gotta catch the Holy Spirit and ride with you all day long. Oh my God. God said, I want to ride with you all day long, baby. I don't want you to just pick me up when you feel like it. God said, I want to ride with you all day long. Woo! I don't care how old you is. God done told y'all. It ain't no young folks gospel and it ain't no old folks gospel. It's one gospel. And God said, I want to ride with you. Woo! Glory be to God. God said, I want to ride with you. And God said, then, when sickness come upon you, oh my God. When pestilence come upon you, oh my God. God said, you ain't worried. You ain't worried. Because you know I'm already with you. I'm already riding with you. I'm already with you, baby. And God said, I'm riding with you till the wheels fall off. I told you, when the wheels fall off, baby, God said, you better pick them up and put them right back on that wagon and keep on riding. Somebody comment on this live, baby, say, ride out. I hear the Lord say, ride out, baby. And I'm finna leave y'all with this. God said, when I make you a promise and I give you a vision, God said, I don't tell you everything that's gonna come ahead of you. I don't tell you everything that you're gonna meet on the path. He don't do that now. Because if he told you everything that you were gonna see, that ain't faith. That ain't faith. He give you a promise. He give you a vision. He shows you the end. He don't tell you. He gonna show you the end now. He gonna show you the end, but he ain't gonna tell you everything you gonna meet in the middle. Oh my God. You don't know about the middle. You don't know what you gonna meet in the middle. And God said, I knew COVID-19, coronavirus, if you please. I knew it was gonna be in the middle. God said, I knew it was gonna meet you head on. God said, I didn't tell you cause I ain't want you worried. I ain't tell you cause I ain't want you to. God said, if I would have told you, that ain't faith. He ain't surprised. He didn't tell us because he wanted us to have faith in him. He wanted us to trust him no matter how the storm blow in our life, no matter how much the wind blow. He wanted us to trust him. Nah, I don't care if you're 5. I don't care if you're 10. I don't care if you're 19. I don't care if you're 29. It's one gospel. And God said, I want to ride with you. I want to ride with you. He said, I want to ride with you all day long. God said, I want to talk to you. Oh my God. I want to show you some things. I want to tell you what's getting ready to come upon you. Because let me tell y'all something. A few months ago, oh my God. A few months ago, God told me to leave everything. Oh my God. I thought I was losing my mind. Y'all don't hear me in here tonight. God told me to leave everything. Oh my God. I told y'all we some eagles in the spirit. Do you understand me? God said, I'm giving my people the spiritual eagle eye. I'm finna let y'all go. But comment on this live, baby, said eagle eye. Ooh. Eagle eye, baby. God giving y'all the eagle eye in the spirit. Let me tell y'all something. An eagle can see up to 3 miles away from him. Oh my God. God said an eagle can see a rabbit moving 3 miles away from him, baby. Ooh, that eagle eye, baby, is sharp. Do you understand me? That eye know is sharp. And God said, I done gave y'all the spiritual eagle eye. God said, I will show you what's coming. He said, I won't tell you exactly what it is, but he said, I will give you warning before destruction. Glory be to God. The eagle eye, baby. God giving y'all the eagle eye in the spirit. A few months ago, God said, leave everything. Oh my God. God said, leave the job. Oh my God. Glory be to God. He said, leave everything. Leave your religion. Oh my God. He told me to leave it. Do you understand me? Glory be to God. I began to tell God, like some of you, but God, how I'm going to do that? God said, but nothing. Do you understand me? God said, but nothing. God said, if I told you that I was going to take care of you, I'm going to do just what I said. Glory be to God. He will put me in isolation before COVID-19 ever even came. Do you understand me? God had already begun to isolate me. God told me, God said, you get on this podcast. God said, you start preaching my gospel into the uttermost parts of the world. Let me tell y'all something. They listening to the podcast all over the world. God said, you're going to preach to the nations. They're going to hear it all over the world. Oh my God. God said, I need you. But let me tell you something, baby. Before God prepare you for your season, God said, I got to back you up. Ooh, he got to put you in isolation, baby. God said, this is a nationwide isolation. Because God said, my people finna get ready to go forth. Because he done called you forth, just like he did with Lazarus. And the enemy done had y'all bound. He done had all them straps on you. But God said, loose them and let them go. Oh, my God. That job that done had y'all, it got to let you go. Oh, my God. That relationship that done had you, it got to let you go. God said, that's my child right there. Loose them, devil, and let them go. And don't you worry about how you going to do that. God said, I am your provider. Glory be to God. God is your provider. Whew. Let me drink me some more water, y'all. Ministering, let me tell you, it'll get you. It'll get you. Because when you minister, you pouring out your virtue. You pouring it out to the people. If you don't believe in virtue, go read the Bible. When the woman that had the issue of blood touched Jesus, and this was the Son of the living God, he stopped in his tracks. He said, who touched me? He said, I felt the virtue when it left my body. When you minister, you prophesy, you preach, you do anything in ministry for God, people, you pouring out your virtue. You giving them your virtue. But it's my calling. Do you understand me? It's why I was born. It's why I'm here. It's why I woke up this morning. So I got to give y'all the gift because he woke me up. And just because he woke me up, that let me know that I got another day. I got another day I got to serve the gift because I'm a servant. I'm your servant. Oh, my God. That's what make you qualify for greatness, baby. Greatness is a service. See, we think it's a good thing to be great. We look at these people. These people are servants to us. They stay up all night long. Oh, my God. They get up early in the morning. But all we see is the glitz and the glam. We see them when they get on camera. We see them when they hit live. Oh, lights, camera, action. But you didn't know everything they did before they got there. You don't know their story. You don't know their process. You don't know the cross that they had to bear until they got to that platform. They are servants. I'm a servant to you, baby. I'm serving my gift. That's all I'm doing. I'm serving y'all my gift. And I hear the Lord say, it's time for you to be a servant. It's time for you to serve the world your gift. You owe me. I'm waiting on you to pay me because you owe me. How I owe you, Toya? You owe me with that gift you got in your belly. You owe your generation. And I hear the Lord say, let me tell y'all something. It's 230 people under the sound of my voice. I hear the Lord say, serve your gifts. Serve your gifts. God said, you better not come back to me with that gift in your belly. God said, I didn't give you that gift for you to bring it back to me. I gave you that gift so you could give it to your generation. Serve the gift. Because you on a time schedule. And I hear the Lord say, y'all better get in a hurry. You better get in a hurry. Do you understand me? You better make haste. Because he gave you that gift, but he put a time limit on it. Oh my God. He put a time limit on it, baby. Get in a hurry. 911 emergency in the spirit. Get in a hurry. Serve your gift. And God said, don't you worry about finances. Don't you worry about the money. I'm a witness. Do you understand me? I'm a witness. A man's gift will make room for him in the world. You ain't got to beg nobody. Oh my God. God said, I will make a way for you. God said, I put that gift in you. And God said, I blessed that gift. Oh my God. He blessed your gift, baby. God said, you ain't never had but a certain amount of money on all your life because you've been doing something that I didn't bless. God said, you better get in this gift because God said, I already blessed your gift. The gift is blessed. Somebody comment on this live, baby, said, my gift is blessed. Ooh, God bless my gift. Whatever your gift is, baby, let me tell you something. God hid it. Ooh, he hid it, baby. He hid it on the inside of you. And you working on a job, and they paying you money, but God said that money is a bribe. Oh, my God. It's a bribe set up by the enemy to get you away from your gift. All our lives, we've been taught that we got to work for somebody. We got to live off of somebody. We need somebody. We need this. We need that. God sent y'all down in this season, baby, because God finna show y'all that everything you need, oh my God, everything you need, he put it inside of you, baby. You loaded. Ooh, somebody comment on this live, baby, said, I'm loaded. Ooh, the grocery stores might be empty, but I'm loaded. Oh my God, you loaded, baby. God done loaded y'all. God done packed y'all full of gifts and callings and talents. Ooh, y'all loaded. And God said, you better not come back to me loaded. God said, when you come back to me, you better be empty. You better empty that thing out. You better be just like Paul. I've been poured out like a drink offering. Oh my God. And I'm ready to be offered up. I hear the Lord say, baby, if you scared to go, that's because you know you ain't did what you're supposed to be doing. You better serve that gift. And everybody gift ain't ministry. Some people got other gifts. God gave all kind of gifts. Some people are gifted with the guitar. Some people are gifted with singing. Some people are gifted with doing hair. Some people are gifted with doing makeup. Some people are gifted with doing nails and feet. Some people are gifted with working with the elderly. Some people are gifted with working with babies. It's some nurses that work in the NICU. And they love what they do because that's their gift. That's what the Lord gifted them to do. How you know if you in your gift? As they say, when that alarm clock go off, are you aggravated? Are you irritated when that alarm clock go off? Are you watching the clock, waiting on the clock to hit 5 o'clock so you can clock out and get out of there? If that's how you feel, you ain't in your gift. And you ain't living, baby. You ain't living till you get in that gift. So let me tell y'all something, baby. I don't care if I ain't got but a dollar to my name. Do you understand me? I'm happy because I'm in my gift. Oh, my God. God told me to leave the job. God told me. God said, I'm going to show you. God said, I'm going to show you that I make a way for you. I'm going to show you that I'm going to bless you. And I came to tell you, baby, if you step out on faith, if you step out on the gift, God is going to bless you. God says some of y'all make wigs. Some of y'all can do hair. Oh my God. Some of y'all good at just doing eyebrows. Whatever your gift is. It ain't got to be ministry, baby. God put all kind of gifts in y'all. God said, whatever you do, do it with excellence. Ooh, God said, I don't care if you buff floors. If buffing floors is your gift, God said, you better do that thing with excellence. Ooh, God said, you better buff that flow so good they say, oh my goodness, who buffed this flow? You better buff it with excellence, baby. That's how they know. That's how you use your gift for the upbuilding and the uplifting of God's kingdom. Because people see your work and they see how good you is at it. And you doing it to glorify God. Everything God bless you with, you bless it with. You bless it with his house. You bless it in his house. You give God his 10%. You be a good manager over what God give you. Because God will stop growth. Where there are no good managers, God will stop growth. Whatever God bless you with in your gift, you better tithe it, baby. You better give. Do you understand me? That's why I put that link down there for y'all to give. If you ain't giving here, you better be giving somewhere. Because God said for some of you, you're going to have to give your way out of this. Oh my God. Give, baby. And you got to give more than you receive. I put that down there, but I give more than I receive. Oh my God. You got to give, baby. Do you understand me? Because the Bible say when you give, it shall be given unto you good measure. Pressed down, shaking together, and running over shall men give to your bosom. Baby, when you start giving to God, folk gonna run you down. They gonna be looking for you. The money gonna look for you. You ain't gonna have to chase the bag. The bag gonna chase you. Glory be to God. I know what God told me. God said, I am a rewarder, baby. God finna get ready to reward y'all. God finna bless all the works of your hand. But you gotta have some work for him to bless, baby. When he come round to bless you, you got to have some work for him. When Jesus came to the fig tree and the tree ain't have no figs, he cursed it. He cursed it from the root. Do you understand me? God said, I'm getting ready to come around to your tree. He coming to your tree. And the Lord said, when I come, I'm looking for some fruit. God looking for some fruit, baby. You got to have some fruit for the master to eat. And if you got some fruit for him, baby, he'll bless it. Oh my God. God said, I bless that thing. God said, I turn that one tree into a field. Oh my God. God said, I'm going to bless you with a whole field of trees, baby. But God said, when I come up on the scene, you got to have some fruit to give me. I'm hungry. I hear the Lord say, the master is hungry and the master want to eat. Now, when he come to your tree, do you got some fruit for him to eat? Where are your works? What you been doing? What you been doing? Since you been home, what you been doing? What you been working on? Oh my God. What you been doing with that gift God put in your belly? What you been doing? Because the master coming back around. Oh my God. He coming back around to your tree. And God said, when I come to your tree, I'm hungry. I want some fruit. What you got for me to eat? Oh my God. I'm finna let y'all go. I got to get back in my private time with God. Let me tell y'all something. I was in private time. And when I came on this live, I just flowed right on over. I flowed right on over into this live. God is good. Woo! I hear the Lord say, go with the flow. Go with the flow of the spirit, baby. Go with the flow. Go with the flow. Go with the flow. Woo! Somebody comment on this live, baby. Say, go with the flow. Edit both say. Go with the flow, baby, and open up your mouth. Ooh! God said, many of you that are on this live, you've been desiring the gift of tongues. You've been wanting to speak in tongues. I hear the Lord say, the fire is in your mouth. God said, open up your mouth by faith. God said, you gonna speak in tongues. Oh my God. God said, I'm gonna purify you with the fire. Oh my God. God said, I'm finna let the rain fall on you. I speak to these dry bones on tonight. It's some dry bones on this live, baby. Oh my God. But I speak to the dry bones on tonight. And I command you to get up and live. Woo! Glory be to God. Get up and live. I declare and I decree that the spiritual rain is gonna fall on every dry bone on tonight. And you gonna get up and live, baby. You gonna get up and live. And you gonna have a testimony. Oh my God. God said y'all gonna have some fire testimony, baby. God said y'all gonna put the devil to shame. Let me tell y'all something. I hate everything that's going on right now. But I love what it's doing for the kingdom. Oh my God. I love what it's doing for God. People, I want y'all to keep this going. Because God gonna bring us out of this. And after God bring us out of this, I want y'all to keep seeking God. I want y'all to keep reaching out to God. Don't let something like this cause you to have to start seeking God. I want you to already be with God, baby. I hate what's going on. I promise you I do. But I love what it's doing for God's people. I love what it's doing for your spirit. God said, I got to shake that body sometime. Oh, my God. He got to shake that body in order to stir up your spirit. I know what I'm talking about, baby. God said, I got to shake that body. I got to touch that body, baby. God said, when I touch that body, they'll start seeking out with their spirit then. Glory be to God. It's not unto death. It's not unto death. Do you understand me? This sickness is not unto death. Oh my God. I know we done lost some people, but I hear the Lord say, your healing is given to you according to your faith. It is not unto death. It's for the glory of God, baby. God gonna get the glory out of this. Somebody comment on this live. Say, God gonna get the glory out of this. Mm-hmm. He gonna get all the glory, baby. Because God said, I am God, and there is none like me. He said, no man gets my glory. Oh, my God. No man. God said, if I gotta shake the White House, I'll do it. Oh, my God. God said, I gotta shake the world. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all, this thing is global. But God showed me the earth. Oh, my God. I'm finna let y'all go. God showed me the earth. God said the world is spinning. Oh, my God. He said it's on an axle and it's spinning on my word. Glory be to God. The earth is spinning on the word of God. Do you understand me? And let me tell y'all something. As you sow into the anointing, I want you to name your seed. Name your seed. Name your seed. There is no required amount. You sow into the anointing according to how God moves you to sow. I don't care if you ain't got but 50 cents, baby. I hear the Lord say, sow it. Do you understand me? I hear the Lord say, sow into the anointing. God says, some of y'all are going to have to sow into the anointing for your healing. You're going to have to sow into the anointing for God to bring you out for your deliverance. Whatever your amount is, baby, you sow it by faith and you name that seed. Oh my God, because a good farmer, when he put a seed in the ground, he know what he planted. Oh my God, he know what he planted. And when he plant that apple seed, he coming back and he gonna look for that apple tree. When you plant that seed, if you plant a seed for your healing, if you sowing a seed for your healing, you better name that thing. You better name that thing. You better say, I'm sowing this seed for my healing in the name of Jesus. I'm sowing this seed for such and such healing in the name of Jesus. And I guarantee you, baby, that thing gonna spring up. It's going to spring up. But you know what? It's got to be watered with faith. It's got to be watered with faith. Somebody drop that in the comments. Water it with faith. You got to water that seed, baby, with faith. Faith is the only thing that's going to make it come forth out the ground. Glory be to God. It's going to come forth in the name of Jesus. Tamika S. Williams, baby, I hear the Lord say, the seed that you have sown, it's going to come forth. Oh, my God. I hear the Lord say, name it. And God said, woman of God, as you name it, so shall I do it for you. God going to move for you. Oh, my God. God is going to move for you. God is going to move for you. And God said, it is done for you according to your faith. It is done for you according to your faith. Glory be to God. Water it with faith. You plant the seed in the ground and you got to water it with faith, baby. And that thing going to bust through. Do you understand me? That thing going to bust through, baby. If you plant that apple seed, God said that apple tree going to come up, baby. It's coming up. If you plant that orange seed, baby, that orange tree is coming up, baby. If you plant that mango seed, that mango tree is coming up. Glory be to God. And y'all know when a tree come forth and it bear fruit, when you cut the fruit open, there's more seed. Oh my God. There's more seed in the fruit. God said, I'm going to bless y'all. Ooh. God said, I'm going to bless you out for your seed. And God said, what I'm going to bless you with? God said, I'm going to give you more so you can sow more. I'm going to give you more so you can do more. I'm going to give you more so you can bless my people. God said, a tree that going to come forth is going to bear fruit, and that fruit going to have more seed in it. Ooh. God said, I'm going to bless the works of your hand, baby. God said, that bank account will be falling over. It'll be running over. I hear the Lord say, overflow, overflow, overflow. Glory be to God. God says overflow. I'm a witness. I know what he'll do. I know what he'll do. Do you understand me? I know what he'll do. God said, I don't lie. I'm not a man that I should lie. Neither am I the son of man that I should repent, baby. God don't lie. Oh, my God. Janice James, I hear the Lord say, you just stepped off in something. Oh, my God. You just stepped off in something, baby. You ain't even know what you were stepping off in. God said, you just stepped off in your blessing, Janice James. Oh, my God. Woman of God, I hear the Lord say, you just stepped off in your blessing. Glory be to God. And God said, whatever that problem is, God said, I'm meeting you in the midst of that problem tonight. I hear the Lord say, Janice James, he's coming to sit down in the furnace with you. Glory be to God. God said, when I get in now, tell me what you need me to do, baby. And God said, whatever you tell me you need, God said, so shall it be done for you. Or you just stepped off in something. Oh, my God. I don't know what was going on before you got on this live, but God said you stepped in right on time. Oh, my God. The devil was trying to fight you, baby, but you got in right on time. Glory be to God. Jesus. I declare and I decree that every seed that has been sown here tonight, oh my God, every seed that's been sown here tonight is going to come forth in the name of Jesus. It's going to bring forth much fruit. Oh my God. Glory be to God. And I declare healing. I declare healing. I don't care what the doctor said. I declare healing. I decree healing. I told y'all when the king make a decree, baby, that's law. You can't vote on what the king said. When the king speak, that's law. That's law. And I decree healing for every COVID-19 positive case in the name of Jesus. I declare healing. Glory be to God. Healing. Because God is bigger than COVID-19. Oh my God. He's bigger. Somebody comment on this live, say he's bigger. He bigger, baby. He bigger than anything I could face. He bigger than anything I could go through. He bigger, baby. God is bigger. Glory be to God. God is bigger. Comment, baby. Say God is bigger. God is bigger. God is bigger. I might be dealing with sickness, but God is bigger. I might be dealing with all kind of mess, but God is bigger. He bigger than what I'm going through. He bigger than what I'm facing right now. God is bigger. And when he speaks, that's law. And God said, let me tell y'all how you know, don't let sneak up on God. He told us in the word. He said, Jesus bore your sicknesses. How did I go see? Jesus bore your sicknesses and your diseases on the cross. And by his stripes, baby, you are healed. By his stripes, you are healed. Let me tell you something. Before the foundation of the world, the lamb was slain. Oh my God. Before the foundation of the world, the lamb was slain. That's how I know God always got a backup plan, baby. You thought Jesus died over 2,000 years ago for your sins. Baby, Jesus died before the foundation of the world. Oh my God. Jesus died before the foundation of the world. And them ain't toy words, them God words. Because the Bible say, before the foundation of the world, the lamb was slain. He gave his life, baby, in the beginning. I told y'all, God ain't surprised. God already got a backup plan. When the devil fooled Adam and Eve, God wasn't worried because God already had a backup plan. And God said, baby, Jesus bore COVID-19 on the cross. Oh, my God. He carried that thing on the cross, baby, before the foundation of the world. God said, don't nothing surprise me. God said, my son already took this thing to the cross. I know y'all feel that. Oh, my God. God said, my son already took COVID-19 on the cross, and he hung there. He bled, and he died. Oh, my God. And God said, this sickness is not unto death. Jesus done already bared that thing. He already dealt with that thing, baby. And you better ride this thing. I don't care what the doctor said. You better ride this thing. Don't y'all give up, because let me tell you something. Your faith is what going to bring you out of this. Jesus already dealt with it, baby. He done already dealt with it. God already had the backup plan in full effect. Don't y'all be fooled. Don't let the devil scare you. God ain't surprised. He already had this thing on backup. Jesus already told it on the cross. He took it to the cross. He hung now. He bled. He died. That's it. That's law. That's it. You out of this. Somebody comment, baby. Say, that's law. That's law. Before God even made you, before he made me, before he made the world, before he made anything, he had a meeting with himself. Oh my God. He had a meeting with himself, with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Oh my God, because they all are one. Oh my God. And he sat down and he had a meeting with himself. He said, I'm giving them free will, but what if they choose? What if they take this free will and they choose against me? Oh my God. What if they choose against me? God had a backup plan, baby. Don't y'all let the devil fool y'all thinking that you done did too much and God don't love you no more and you done sinned too much. You can't out-sin the love of God. Somebody drop that in the comments, baby. I don't care what you did. You could be a renegade. You could be ruthless. You could be a straight-up rebel. God still love you, baby. You could be coming down the pole every night. God still love you. He love you just like he loved me. You could be slinging drugs, baby. God still love you. Do you understand me? When God look at you, God still say, that's my child. Oh, my God. That's my child. Do you understand me? And God said, I had a backup plan. God said, before you start slinging them drugs, before you start coming down that pole, God said, I already had a backup plan for you. God said, many are the plans in a man's heart, but the Lord's purpose for that man shall prevail. God gonna get his way. And that's what I'm gonna leave y'all with. God gonna get his way. He gonna get his way. And God done spoke some things over y'all. And God said, y'all gonna do what he told you you were gonna do. You don't see how you gonna do it. But that's because you don't see what God put in you. I see it. And I'm speaking to it tonight. You gonna do what God made you to do. You gonna fulfill your purpose. And you gonna walk in your divine calling. And I'm like Forrest Gump. That's all I got to say about that. I love y'all with a divine love. Every single person that has sowed into this ground, name your seed. And I declare and I decree that it shall come forth. Water it with faith, baby. Water your seed with faith. Water it with faith. And I declare and I decree that it shall come forth in the mighty name of Jesus. I love you. I love you. I love you all. I done preached till my computer went off. Y'all hear me? I love y'all. I love y'all. I love y'all. I will be going live again this week. Y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. Make sure y'all stay tuned. Share this live if y'all have not already shared it. So anybody that's coming on the replay, they can get this anointing, okay? They can get these words. Y'all make sure y'all share, okay? And invite people to join the Divine Ones. The Divine Ones is my Facebook group. So y'all come and join the group. It's a public group. We do this all the time in the Divine Ones. I love you all. I love you all. You all are always in my prayers. I pray for you constantly, okay? When I'm in my shower, I'm praying for you. When I'm ironing my kids' clothes, well, I ain't been doing no ironing now because we ain't going nowhere. But when I'm tending to my kids, when I'm cooking, when I'm washing clothes, okay, when I'm tending to my dog, when I'm tending to my kids doing it, I'm always praying. I'm always praying. So when y'all hit me up like, Toya, pray for me, I'm like, okay, but you ain't telling me nothing I wasn't already doing. Unless you got something specific that you want me to pray about, okay? Something specific. But when I pray over y'all, I pray over every single thing that you could possibly be dealing with. Because the Father knows. Even when I don't know, some things he'll reveal to me now through prophecy. Some things he won't. Some things he'll reveal to me and I can't tell you right then. I can't speak on it yet. Because just because the Lord gives you a prophecy don't mean you can speak on it. You got to wait. Let that thing go through your spirit a little bit, and then wait for God to tell you whether you should speak on it or not. Y'all know how that go. But praying for your family. I love you all so very much. Y'all know what I always tell y'all on the podcast. If you can see it in your mind, you can hold it in your hand. With God, all things are possible. Okay? I'll see you guys next time. Y'all hold up the light now. Don't throw away your faith. Hold on to your faith. That's your confidence in God. Hold on to it, okay? Because God ain't left you, and God is coming. He's coming. He's faithful. And that's one thing I can tell you about God. He's faithful. If he said it, you better believe it, because God is faithful. I love you all so much. I'm praying for you all. Y'all be blessed. This has been LaToya O'Keel, your spiritual life coach and your motivational speaker. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.